сам возьму. А, ну, спасибо.
До свидания, вам, товарищ.
Очень приятно было.
Вам тоже. До свидания.
Вот запах техники.
Alexei! Why are you running away?
I wasn't.
What's the matter? Was I pronouncing your name wrongly or something? And why didn't you stop? This is Alexei. This is a colleague of mine, Tim Castle.
Oh, hello.
Haven't seen you for ages. Alexei is some sort of a journalist.
Oh, I am a journalist. Stationed here, are you? I thought only soldiers were stationed.
Posted. You're posted here.
Yes.
And enjoying it, I trust?
Yes. Now, if you'll excuse me, I do have to put these parcels on the plane to Moscow.
We just had a really joyous time. We were stuck at the airport the whole bloody night trying to put a Spanish fish expert on the plane. Fish rights and all that endless rubbish.
I think I'll be going, Nicholas. I'm completely exhausted.
Fine, yeah, of course.
Silly little creep's been complaining all night.
He's ambitious, too. He's much younger than he looks. He's one of those deceptive types. They seem harmless, but aren't.
Come on, Alexei. There's nobody here yet. I'd like to do with some help. Won't take a moment.
Look, but there should be someone here.
Won't take a moment.
Don't look so alarmed. We're just trying to drown our impatience with absolutely no success whatever, of course. It's all right, you can come in. There's nobody here. Nobody watching. Yes, he bought a lot of soft porn for the flight, which he seems to have left behind. Foreign Office hospitality. What do you think?
So this is how you entertain people, is what you get up to. You started to draw pictures on the walls.
Well, can you imagine what it was like spending Saturday night in here? I was going to a party last night, do you realize? It sounded distinctly promising. I intend to make up for it right now.
Yes, well...
Alexei, you couldn't just help me clear up, could you? How do you pronounce that right, don't I? Alexei, that is right, isn't it?
It'll do. I really do have to put these parcels on plane for Moscow.
Yes, we just have to do this first. It won't take a moment. We just have to give a vague impression of having tidied up. That's all that's necessary. Come on. Just as a matter of interest, not wishing to pry or anything, but what are you doing up here on a Sunday morning?
Trying to put these parcels on the plane for Moscow.
Oh, yes, of course. And what's in them?
Excuse me?
The parcels. What's inside them?
My articles, the pieces I've written.
Yes, and?
Well, you wouldn't believe me.
How do you know? Try me.
English television programs? Videotapes of television programs.
Well, why not? At least I've managed to wangle some duty-frees out of all this. Illegally, of course. You must have some.
Come on, hurry up. I've got a plane to catch. My flight's been announced. I'm sorry to barge in on this, probably a second. Right, how am I doing here? I'm going to Australia. See, so gate 1, 2, 3, 4. How much is that, huh?
Moskovsky samolot. Уже улетел.
Нет, еще не улетел.
I mean, you have to pay for them as well. You can't just throw them on the plane.
No, I do this instead.
Oh.
Really don't believe me, do you?
Автобус уходит. Давайте скорее, а то опоздаете.
Was that the bus home?
Yes.
Well, don't worry, there's no problem. I'll give you a lift into town.
I'd rather take a taxi. I have things to do, to think about.
This is ridiculous. It'll cost you the rest of your year's wages. Come on.
You haven't been drinking all night, have you?
I've been shut up in a box the whole bloody night in order to protect our fishing rights. What do you expect?
Well, it's just that, I mean, you normally pick up people at airports whom you know only very slightly. I mean, just pick them up.
Extraordinary question. Relax, don't worry. Nobody's going to get hurt. On the way there, I thought we might drop in on that party I was going to last night.
Yes, if you could just let me off on this corner. I have to get home. It's something rather urgent.
Come on, you deserve a chance to relax.
Why?
All those endless hours of having to be polite.
Oh, I'm expecting a letter from my wife rather badly, and the post hadn't arrived before I left.
There's no post on a Sunday in this country.
Oh, yes, of course. I always forget.
Come on. What have you got to lose? I only hope this is the right house.
Ah.
So you finally decided to arrive.
Christ, are we late? I thought you said about 8. No, I've been working.
You've just missed a really foul party, anyway.
Oh.
A really foul collection of people. I thought I'd never get rid of them.
Of course, I chose to spend Saturday night at the airport. They have such fantastic food there now. There's a terrific floor show.
God, there's smoke in here. I don't know anybody who enjoys their own parties. Do you? I certainly hate mine. Glad you could come.
Yes. It's first time. I don't think I've ever been to a party at 8 o'clock in the morning before.
Anyway, I bought you all the Sunday papers.
Somebody read them for me and tell me what to go and see. Anyway, you can start clearing up, since you were so punctual.
What, me to clear up? I've only been here 2 minutes. Certainly I'll clear up, come on.
So you had to spend the whole night with the alien, did you?
No, I met him in the morning.
Sorry.
I'm sorry, I seem to have got myself lost.
Yes?
Looking for the bathroom. Every room I walk into seems to have a naked woman lying in it.
It's behind you. The bathroom.
I'm sorry. I was only joking. Not every room. I've only found one so far.
God, I hate Sundays. Celia? Celia? I'm furious when she started tearing up. Celia? Christ, people must be grinding their teeth after making this noise on a Sunday morning.
Come on, everyone. I think we ought to get going. Or someone spots will be making all this noise.
What are you doing? Are you coming with us?
Coming where?
To breakfast, of course. I'm absolutely starving.
What's the matter? You're allowed to have an English breakfast occasionally, aren't you?
No, it's not encouraged.
Ah.
Some enormous sausage.
Do you think it's okay? Anyway, and the next door room, this is really amazing.
Sometimes you can get really
in the next door.
Okay. They were dressed up as bits of vegetation.
I've changed my mind. I'm beginning to need my bed rather violently, otherwise I'm liable to start misbehaving.
Oh, well.
No, don't be absurd. Yeah. You eat your food. Enjoy yourself. I'll see you all soon.
Bye.
Bye.
Bye. Oh, and by the way, I won't be coming to the wedding on Wednesday.
What?
I can't, I'm afraid. Sudden change of plan.
Are you going to be all right without him?
Oh, yes, I think I'll survive.
Anyway, there they were singing their lungs out amongst all these junkies. It was absolutely amazing.
Oh. No, it's all right, it's fine. There's no problem.
About the wedding, we shan't be going either, so we won't be able to give you a lift.
Oh, for Christ's sake. There isn't any bloody station. It's in some remote part of Sussex. How are we going to get there? Come on, tell me.
Train.
There isn't any station. I just told you that.
If it's in Sussex?
Yes.
Well, I could take you there. I have to go to Sussex for a day next week. I could. I mean, it is the least I could do.
You know that area, do you? Round there?
Sussex? Oh, yes, intimately.
You mean you're just allowed to go anywhere you like? Just pop into a car and rush off?
Well, there is a 15-mile limit, but I can get permit very easily.
By Wednesday?
Oh, yes.
Thanks, but I don't think that will be necessary.
Well, if you change your mind, you let me know, yes?
Excuse me. Who do I ask for? You have your own phone, do you?
Oh, yes. We've got around to using those, too. Alexei Veryov. Let me know. Talking with someone, I won't be a minute.
Hello.
This is Celia. Francis couldn't wait any longer. Can you come?
Yes.
10:30 tomorrow, 17 Addison Avenue.
Okay.
We had a little excitement today where I live. There was a man who was so eager to get back to Russia that he got drunk and jumped out of a window and started to smash up anything he could see. It worked. They're sending him home.
He was that eager to get home. Seems very bizarre.
Not too Russian.
What do you really do?
I'm a kind of journalist.
Kind of?
Well, I'm a writer, actually. I had several books published at home. Very good reviews.
Please watch the road.
I'm here just to help out. Temporary assignment. They wanted somebody to write about things that the main correspondent didn't have time to cover. I mean, I could write about this wedding if I like.
And your wife? Do you have a wife?
Oh, yes. She was here. She got a little homesick. I let her go home.
Enough to bring us all the way down.
My pleasure. It's delighted I was able to come.
I must get some champagne.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
You look beautiful.
Thank you. Hello.
I understand you're from Russia.
Yes, I believe that's so.
I do hope there's something here you can find to eat.
Excuse me?
Something here you're used to eating.
Oh, thank you. I'll search hard.
Watch out, he's taking pictures. Watch out, he's taking pictures.
You know them well, do you? Mary and what's his name, the bridegroom?
Oh, no, I'm afraid I don't know.
Oh. I didn't catch. Where did you say you came from?
I didn't. I come from Soviet Union.
Good Lord. They let you out today.
Well, not exactly. You see, I still live there. I'm a Soviet citizen.
And they allow you to go to weddings and things?
Uh-huh.
Oh, that's extraordinary. Maybe you can drop us a postcard when you're going to start, you know, dropping the big one. I've started digging in my garden a shelter, you know, just in case. Have you been to Alaska?
Not recently, no.
You used to be Russian, you know. Well, then what do you do?
Anything undercover? I am Yugoslavian film director. My latest piece, just finished shooting, is called The Solitary Bicyclist Rides into the Canal.
I thought I'd visit the club. I got as far as the door. Afraid they'd ask me about you. Don't get around much anymore. I've been invited on dates. I could have gone but not for. I'm awfully different without you. I don't get around much anymore.
Thank you. I must just go and keep an eye on next door. They must be about to cut the cake.
Hello.
Why are you here? You're not meant to be here. I didn't think you would be.
Why?
Well, you could have given them lift. There's no reason for me to be here at all, is there?
What makes you think that? I can't stand having other people in the car when I'm driving. And don't look so paranoid. They've done very well, haven't they? Quite a collection. But the happy couple seem to have disappeared. Alexei, you know about this taping of television thing? Well, it just so happens, incredible though it may seem, that I was on the box the other night, a little sort of documentary thing about the FO, and I just wondered if you might have it taped.
I might have.
Great. Couldn't show it to me, could you?
Maybe.
Next week, perhaps?
Maybe. You really don't believe me, do you?
Of course I believe you. Wouldn't be asking otherwise.
I have an appointment. A British Council dinner. I mustn't be late back.
What are you doing? I always make straight for here. That's usually something I want. Don't you ever do this? Anyway, they always get two of everything. Anything you fancy?
Not really, not stealing.
Come on, have one of these.
Don't be absurd.
No need to worry, I gave it to them. I've decided to take it back.
I refuse.
Excuse me, come on.
Never
you better get out of here.
Are you going to London?
I didn't say anything about driving you back as well.
If you could just find room.
I expect you grew up in a house like that. Did you?
No. Not really, no.
This is what I imagined all of England looked like before I came here. And full of brightly coloured steam engines and men in top hats. I saw them in the old-fashioned English children's books we had at school. The sleekest landscape in all the world, none of your famous writers called it. I'll tell you something else if you want. I didn't get the 15-mile clearance to make this trip in the illegal journey.
Thought you probably hadn't.
I forged the pass in case we're stopped. I've done it one or two times before. I've never been stopped. This formality, it'll be fine. No problem. I expect we'll hit the main road soon. I expect we'll hit it in a moment. I don't know what happened, everything just went blank. This round you keep warm.
He fell asleep.
Only for a moment. Let's push. Can you push? Let's get this thing back on the road.
Are you all right? Can I help at all?
No, we can manage, thank you.
Looks like she's in rather a mess.
No, we're perfectly all right, thank you.
Okay, fine.
He was probably following us. I don't know, maybe.
Following us?
Oh, yes, we usually followed. If you're sufficiently well known to them, it depends how busy they are. But the weather's like them, is any good on television? Unfortunately, we're a little conspicuous now, but when we get back to London within the limit, everything should be fine.
Sort of feeling, isn't it? It's like coming into a foreign city. Places that before looked totally harmless look different. And not knowing whether totally normal-looking people are following you or not.
I thought that might happen. Now, he won't be able to resist stopping us. We must make quite a spectacle looking like this. He's bound to make him suspicious. Don't worry, I'll handle it. Yes, now he's taken my number and he'll pass it on. It'll start to go through your home office. Well, we made it back anyway. Would you like to see where I work? Now standing on Russian territory. You're not, of course, but sounds good. And I like the view. I had no idea how to decorate it, so I decided not to.
So this is where it all happens.
All happen? What do you think happens? You like to look in some drawers? Look to some postcards. A few back numbers of time out. Some dead moths, that's all. Well, this is where I sit and write my articles. And I observe from here.
Observe?
And in spare moments, I'm writing novel. It's an English story, sort of pale ghost story. It's a mixture of Dostoevsky and Sherlock Holmes, but in my own style, of course.
Is that all you do here?
What do you mean, all? Everybody thinks that I'm involved in espionage of some kind. Absolutely everybody, even the bloody taxi drivers. The fact is, quite simply, I would not know where to begin. I'm too impatient. I would be quite hopeless at all this waiting around for hours and hours to collect messages out of holes in trees, that sort of thing. But nobody believes me.
You have to expect that. Won't anybody get worked up about you having left London without proper clearance and then having an accident?
I hope they do.
You hope? Why?
Listen. The last 2 days, a person whom I know only very slightly picks me up at airport and practically drags me into his car. Having gone through the most amazing play acting first to try to persuade me that he spent the night there on some foreign office business when it was quite clear that he was there to meet me. Then he bullies me, or if you like, encourages me to go to a party at 8 o'clock in the morning. And when I get there, I find the place full of naked women walking around the room. And then he invents this drive to Sussex. He's quite clear, unless you are an imbecile. British are trying to compromise me. Francis is involved, perhaps. Maybe.
Yes? What were you going to say?
Nothing! Doesn't matter! They want me out of here, your Secret Service. That is obvious. And I tell you, I'm going to let them.
Let them?
I have decided I need to get home. I agreed to 2 years, but now I need to get back. So I'm taking a shortcut, breaking a few minor rules, behaving a little outrageously. And as I'm being watched very closely all the time, the British will ask me politely to leave, as you will see.
Won't that get into some sort of trouble when you get back home? If you're involved in a scandal?
Nonsense. English, you have such primitive grasp of these matters. It's all so black and white.
Thank you.
There'll be no scandal. There'll be just a quiet but sudden reposting. Listen, I did them a favor in coming here. I'm just hurrying my return, that's all. Oh, I assure you, I did not plan accident. That was unexpected bonus. You look suspicious.
Do I? I believe you.
I don't expect you to.
I'd like to read your English ghost story sometime.
Yes?
If you finish it.
Anyone there?
No, I don't think so.
Been rather extraordinary day, hasn't it? One of the best since I've been in this country. Yes, it's me speaking. I just got back. You timed your call perfectly.
Yes. You got back all right then?
Of course. Why? Why you ask?
No reason. Don't sound so jumpy. I just wondered if you fancied a drink with me.
Drink? Yeah, it might be possible.
Good. Should we say, no, not tomorrow. What about Tuesday at about 5:30?
Okay, fine.
And by the way, don't forget to bring the tape. If you've got it. You know, the thing I mentioned.
That the All England Tennis Club, we always have to face the eternal problem of how to improve the facilities without in any way interfering with the traditions of the place, which, of course, is world famous. Not just the atmosphere, but the general flavor of the place. Well, that's our way of thinking anyway.
I'm sorry, I wasn't listening. I haven't been listening to what you were saying.
I thought you wanted to write about English tennis.
No, it really doesn't matter anymore.
Then why did you arrange for
my friend, my mind is too full of useless facts, I'm afraid. I have been a little over-conscientious since I've been here. I'm expecting to be recalled at the end of the week, so it would be unfair to waste any more of your valuable time. So please, complain to whoever you have to complain to. We'll give my successor something to do.
Can I give you a lift?
Where to? You don't know where I'm going.
I can take you anywhere you like.
I don't think you can mean that. Anywhere?
Yes, but starting tomorrow.
Following me?
Was I following you? I was just passing.
You want to see me? If you want to, you can. Do you want to?
Yes.
In the cafe then where we had breakfast. On Monday at 5 o'clock, okay?
Better. You've changed your image, I mean. Why'd you do it? Do you want to be unrecognizable? Why'd you do it?
No. It was just an experiment. Is that your car?
Oh, yes.
Sorry, Fred. You can't do that. This is a Russian car, Soviet diplomatic business.
Double yellows, I'm afraid, sir. Double yellows.
No. You just take the number, and here is my name,
and you make your complaint to whoever you meant to complain to.
Yes, I'm afraid I have to.
Right, now make sure you do that, okay?
So, you haven't been sent home yet? Didn't you get your reposting?
No, any day. But you British are a little sluggish in these matters. I may have to do something bigger. Do what Guy Burgess did in Washington when he was desperate to be recalled. Go on mad drunken spree or something. No, really, I might have to.
Don't think I'll come with you this time.
I saw that on television over here. I have no other connection with British double agents, I assure you.
Are you going to help me? Somebody might help me. I knew we shouldn't have shopped around here. That was a filthy place in there to have tea.
This is my mother.
I've got to hurry, catch the train. Your father will be home. I hate being in London. We all thought you'd forgotten your father's birthday.
I've got to go this way now, Mum.
Oh, yes. Well, nice to see you, dear. Don't forget.
Who is she? That old woman isn't really your mother, is she?
Yes.
She looks like a stranger.
I have to go. Francis is giving a dinner party. I said I'd help. You could come if you want. Why don't you? You better go.
Yes, of course, at once.
I'm sorry, I did go over the top. You look terrified.
Because we know that you're a man of wide interests. Not the usual anonymous party hack, but the type of person that we like to deal with. As a matter of fact, we've been reading your articles about England and the English scene. We managed to obtain some copies of them. We found them surprisingly amusing. Not perhaps very accurate, but very amusing.
Yes, I was very surprised. I didn't know you had it in you, Alexei. But your writing is marvellous.
stunning.
We know that in your own country you're considered as, well, apart from everything else, a very considerable talent. Rapidly becoming quite a literary celebrity, I understand. Indeed, you're really rather famous. And although we've been forced to take this regrettable action because you've broken the rules, we wouldn't like you to think that it was anything personal.
I'm going to miss you, Alexei.
We've managed to order some of your books. They're going to become required reading for all members of the department. Perhaps if we had time, you might sign a few.
There you are.
Oh, Nicholas. I have come on the right day, haven't I, for our drink?
Yes, of course. This way.
That's one of our undersecretaries. I think you best avoid him.
It's quite incredible the amount of bloody fools in this building. A lot of them go amazingly far.
Well.
Yes?
Have you bought the tape?
No, of course not. I didn't believe you were serious. I don't tape everything, you know. I haven't got the time. I have my work to do.
That's a pity.
I could show you other tapes if you wished to prove to you that I really have been doing that.
But why should I want that? No, I just rather fancied seeing myself on telly, that's all. A very primitive desire, I admit. I have a ludicrous yearning for that kind of celebrity.
That. Yes, I see.
You could be very useful to me, Alexei.
Yes?
I could catch up on all sorts of telly I miss. I'm sure Moscow wouldn't mind.
Have you got any news for me?
News?
Yes.
What kind of news would you like?
You know perfectly well.
Come on, Alexei, drink up. You know, for some reason, you look different. What have you been doing to yourself? Huh? Maybe it's the clothes you're wearing.
I'm leaving England at any moment, as I'm sure you probably know. These must be my last few days. So, as it seems I'm being given a chance, I've decided to enjoy myself. A unique opportunity. I'll do whatever I like. I warn you.
Would you like a drink or a bar snack?
No, thank you. Oh, Prestige. Sorry.
Sir, would you like a drink or a bar snack?
No, thanks.
Would you like a drink?
You don't mean you work here?
Yes.
course I do. What do you think I'm doing here? Can I get you a drink?
No.
This is our common room. It's a nice informal atmosphere, as you can see.
You never told me you work here. Hey, you never told me you work at all.
You never asked me. What are you doing here, anyway?
I would never have guessed you were a waitress.
Surprisingly comfortable, actually.
And your name pinned on.
Yes. Sometimes we swap them round for fun. Mind see anyone misspelt for some reason? Celia with an H.
Ah, yes.
I quite like it, actually.
So, your locker, what number is your locker?
330.
330, 40, 38, 36. 2, 4, 4, 4, 4. This one.
It's nothing very interesting. A little light reading. Frivolous, really.
Oh, chocolate. Yeah.
Oh, chocolate.
What the hell do you think you're doing? Did anybody give you permission to take your supper break early? Did they?
I wasn't taking
and
my supper break.
And what on earth are you playing at, bringing men in here?
I was just going to lend...
I know what you were just doing. Hello? Hotel.
I'm sorry that happened because of me. That revolting small man fanning us. I hope I haven't lost your job. We've only got 10 minutes of your supper break left.
Doesn't matter. I'm not bothered about going back. I was going to leave there anyway. I'm glad. Quite used to being driven around London in a Russian car.
If you like, but only if you want to, I'll show you inside our official residence.
Okay. Why not?
It's the first time I've ever tried to do this. Nobody will notice. No, well, no, you're not Russian. Selyushka.
Alexei, добрый вечер.
Добрый.
А это кто?
Девушка из Аэрофлота.
Из Аэрофлота? Ну, гуляйте. До свидания.
До свидания.
Алексей, не забудь про статью.
Да, да. He's from embassy, a cultural attaché. I don't have much in common with those people. A genuine idiot. I told him you worked in our Aeroflot office.
Does that mean I've got to talk about aeroplanes in Russian?
No, no, we shouldn't meet anybody else. There's Russian evening at the Barbican Center. My room's just down here. Там нет порнографии.
Что нет? Нет.
Слушай, красавица, как вас зовут?
Это Селюшка.
Селюшка? Здравствуйте, очень приятно, очень приятно.
Значит, Ельна.
Селюшка, Селюшка, смотри. У нас есть маленькая вечеринка сегодня. Пожалуйста, приходите, повеселимся немножко, выпьем. Ну как?
Слушай, мы обыскали
нет.
Все?
Да нет,
что
нет,
такое все время?
Ну, приятно, но что вы в самом деле? Уже весь ужин остыл.
Тише!
Что это такое?
Слушайте, она только что приехала.
Давайте, что вы с вашими плюшками? Хорошо, пойдем. Возьмите ее с собой. Ну что это такое? Ну пошли, ну,
Лиза, давайте. Пойдем.
Ну, пошли. Молодец,
нашел. They sometimes rave like tapes. They like the football.
Oh, you see me in my lair. It's pretty bloody cold, yes?
They keep it cold on purpose just to make you feel at home.
Maybe.
It's not very tidy.
Oh, yes. I use these in the theatre.
Of course.
Ever since my wife returned to Russia, I've let it grow wild.
You must miss her. Do people watch you from here? Peer at you from the tops of tall buildings.
Yes. And I peer back.
Looks really strange from here. Are they watching now?
Almost certainly. But they're taking surprisingly long time to act. How are you waitress and also know Francis?
I met Francis when I first came down to London. Through a boy. Boy I went out with for a month. He took me to her parties. It was another world. Like visiting another planet. An alien place, but quite interesting, all those people. Rich young things. Francis and me became friends. Kind of friends. Francis hates me doing that job. She won't talk about it. I can't see anybody watching. Are these your machines?
Yes.
I used to have terrible fights with my father about television. He'd always switch over if there was anything interesting on, switch over to rubbish. He liked his daughters to do what he wanted. Always. I think I'll get undressed now.
You don't have to do that, you know.
Of course I don't have to.
There's no rush. Russians are allowed to sleep with women. Maybe people are not going to come running through the door with flashlights like in the movies.
I know, I just... I just would like, if you don't mind, if I could, I'd like to spend the night here. Just tonight. To stay.
Of course. But you don't have to pay me like that. Not unless you want to, of course.
Oh, did I didn't mean to look like a...
Just a little. There's no violent hurry. People are often amazed at a time like this. They expect all Russians either to be compulsive dissidents or incapable of intelligent talk except slogans. I'm a casual sort of member of the party, but I belong to my country. Just like all the people I meet here. It's part of one. Of one's soul. One accepts the virtues and the faults. Exactly like people here. But they don't understand that. They expect me to be bowed down by ideological turmoil. I say to them, I hate this tit-for-tat, that expression. I hate that sort of conversation. But do they think about Northern Ireland every moment of every day of their lives? Of course they don't. Anyway, I'm a writer, not a politician. What I really want to be is a naive fantasy of many men of my generation. I wish to be film director. Should have been me that filmed War and Peace. I have an eye for things. I'm like camera lenses, one of your writers said, and it may just be becoming possible when I get home. Please, don't do that, tidying everything.
No, that's all right. Do you bring real Aeroflot stewardesses in here?
No.
So I won't find any uniforms under the bed. Do they always make this amount of noise? There used to be a man downstairs at Francis's who shrieked every quarter of an hour between 1 and 3 o'clock in the morning, like a clock. And he's shrieking. Well, it was more of a squeal than a shriek, really. Francis always used to sleep through it. Well, almost always. He went off eventually. That's it. I'm sorry, there isn't any punchline. I hope nothing terrible happens to you because I stayed here.
No. Just the opposite. It'll help me get home.
Mr. Varyov,
yes. A telephone call for you around the corner on the left. First left.
Hello?
Oh, I must have paid someone. Have somebody paid?
It's you. Where are you?
Doesn't matter. I was just wondering. I wonder if you could meet this afternoon. It's very short notice. It may be inconvenient. It's just if you could.
I'm afraid I can't. I have too many goodbye errands to do, and I have to clear out my papers.
That's all right, don't worry. I've got to go now. I'll be at the cafe, the same one, the day after tomorrow. That's Friday at 4 o'clock. Be there if you can. Thanks.
Sorry. We're closed now.
Thank you.
Wait for the tone.
Celia, why did you not show up? Alexei.
Hello, is Celia there?
Francis Oliver is not here at present. If you'd like to leave a message, you may do so. After a pause.
Is that you, Francis? It's not a machine at all, is it? Can I speak to Celia?
Celia's disappeared.
What do you mean?
Celia's disappeared.
You're not that girl I was with. Celia.
She hasn't been back since Saturday. I haven't seen her.
She hasn't been in touch with you. You've no idea.
No idea.
Well, could I see for myself? You know, your common room.
What?
The lockers.
Oh, you're not allowed in there.
I suppose you'll tear the door down, won't you, if I don't let you in?
Has she vanished like this before?
No.
I think that it might have something to do with me. That's why I'm worried. She might be involved in something that I don't know about. Can I see her bedroom, please?
No. But since you're going to anyway, it's over there. You won't find anything in there.
What are these?
She used to write stories. She hasn't done for a long time, though. Put them back exactly where you found them. You don't leave this flat very soon. It means I will have to. Unless, of course, you're going to use force and hold me here.
Understand why you're being so hostile about it.
Then you must be spectacularly naive.
You really do believe that I'm the enemy, don't you? Do I look like it?
I know exactly what you are. I did the first time I saw you.
Then why did you start all this in the first place? By asking me for a lift, if you felt...
That was Celia's idea.
Don't you want to know where she is? After all, she's your friend. Aren't you curious?
God, you're an insensitive little man, aren't you? Get out, please, before I start to scream.
Could you get us a taxi in 5 minutes, please?
What on earth are you doing here? You've discovered me uncharacteristically working late.
Sorry to burst in on you like this, but there's something I needed to ask you urgently.
It must be, mustn't it?
I will be quick. You know that girl you introduced me to?
I haven't introduced you to anybody.
You know, Francis' friend.
Oh, yes. What was her name? I've forgotten her name.
Celia.
That's right.
She's disappeared.
Has she?
Where is she?
I haven't the slightest idea. Why should I know that?
You introduced us, for God's sake. You engineered our meeting.
You're being totally incomprehensible, Alexei. Explain to me, why on earth should I want to do that?
You know perfectly well that you encouraged me to, how to put it, to take risks. It happens all the time. We know how the British Secret Service works. They must have asked you because we knew each other slightly, just as in Moscow sometimes.
It's total gibberish. Whatever's been happening to you has not involved me.
Then why did you pick me up for a lift then and take me to party?
To amuse myself, why ever else? To ease the boredom.
So, do you know where she is?
Asking me twice, I'm afraid, won't make any difference. Why are you so worried about her? She seemed to me rather a dull little thing.
I'm curious. Listen. If you won't tell me, then you must know someone other than Francis who knows her. There must be somebody else.
Please don't start shouting, okay? I'm not exactly happy about you being here at all at this time. Having a Russian in the office in the afternoon is one thing, but at this time of night, you might look a trifle eccentric.
Why people should worry about that now.
Oh, come on, Alex. Everybody knows you're a spy. The whole of London knows, I should think. Just what sort of a spy, I haven't the faintest idea, nor am I really that interested either. You have the most outrageous cover story the world has ever known.
Oh, for God's sake, Nicholas, we can't argue about this now. I will never make you believe me, that's clear. Just try to understand. I would like to find this girl before I go home.
For the third time.
I don't believe you! Just can't be true.
I must insist, Alexei, that you leave me alone. I am being deliberately conscientious at the moment out of necessity, and I do not want that to be disrupted. Now, I want you to get out of my office.
Yes, but please, just one...
Otherwise, I shall have to call security, won't I?
Get in, I'll give you a lift.
What are you doing following me?
Just get in for a moment, please, come on. I'll give you a lift wherever you want to go, just get in. You remember who I am?
Yes. What on earth do you think you're doing?
I just need somebody to talk to, even you. People are backing off me at the moment like a small box. Tell me, where are your Secret Service, Come on, why haven't they picked me up? Since I've committed very serious offences, broken all the rules, there's no sign of them.
Really?
Why?
Well, how should I know? Now, are you going to let me out? But where are you taking me?
How do I look for somebody? How do I find somebody in this city?
I haven't the remotest idea. Let me out of this car!
Thank you. Excellent. Cheers.
Well, would you come with us, please?
Me?
Yes, you, please.
Oh, thank God you've come.
Your ticket.
One, please.
You certainly have taken your time.
Car keys.
Oh. What have you been doing? To be picked up waiting outside cinema and movie queues. Very appropriate, like Dillinger, American Gangster.
You like the movies, do you?
Oh, yes.
As you see, we're still in the process of moving.
I just have to do this.
Of course.
It's just a formality.
I've never known such thing. I consistently go out of London illegally in broad daylight with forged permit. I hang around government buildings at night. While drunk, I leave motor car crammed full of incriminating evidence right outside police station. Now, what happens? Absolute silence. I was beginning to wonder if you knew your job.
That's surprisingly helpful. Let's see if this is recording.
I consistently go out.
Good. Well, if we just, if we continue in this vein, we may all even get some sleep tonight. Now, you're Vladimir Bugin.
No. Wrong for start. I am Alexei Veryov.
Yes, now, come on, there's no point...
No, listen, I tell you. That's who I am. Alexei Veryov, here. I don't even look like Bugin.
Got the wrong one. They must have given us the wrong car number he's using tonight.
Who the hell are you there, Knife? One, I've never heard of you. Let's see where you are on the betting order. Oh, no. Shit, that's who you are. Well, this would happen, wouldn't it? Well, I don't think you're of any interest at all to us, in fact.
How do you mean?
I mean exactly that, low security ranking. Your wife left you to return to Moscow 6 months ago.
My wife did not leave me. She just wished to go back to Russia.
Yes, part-time journalist. As you were aware, your articles are no longer being published in the Soviet Union.
But that is complete rubbish. I receive copies of papers all the time. My articles are there.
How recently was this?
Well, not recently, because there's been a backlog. I myself... Well, if it was true, why haven't they been appearing?
How should we know?
Perhaps people didn't understand them. Perhaps other people have been using your material.
Partly the main reason he's being kept on here is that many highly placed officials have been enjoying the steady flow of taped English television programmes of which he is the main source.
But that is obviously completely untrue. It would hardly be reason to keep me here.
I see that 4 previous applications from you to return home early have been turned down.
So I remember we discussed him, didn't we? We had that meeting with the Russians in Windsor. And he's of no interest to us.
You seem to be slightly misinformed about everything.
I assure you there is one thing we are not. This is a bloody nuisance, isn't it?
I am sorry to be the cause of administrative inconvenience.
Couldn't we just put him back on the street where we found him?
No, afraid we can't do that much as I'd like to. Not after he's admitted all that, forged permits, etc. We have it on record as well. We have to kick it up further. Otherwise, we might be starting a nasty precedent. They may start feeling they can get away with anything.
Well, let me ask you this. If all this is true, indeed, any of it, why have you been following me?
Nobody's been following you.
Not at all, but I thought...
No. I don't know that your people will exactly be overjoyed with you either.
That's putting it mildly.
Now, you will return to your place of residence and stay there until you receive official notification from us. You should not leave there at all for any reason. Normal procedure, of course, in these circumstances. This will go on up, and within the next 24 hours, you will be quietly asked to pack your bags and leave. Right, wait there. We'll drop you off as we have a moment.
Is that Celia's mother? Mrs. Watson, is that you?
Celia's not here. What do you want?
This is the man that you met with Celia. The man from Russia. I don't know where she is. I just wondered if...
Yes? Are you there?
Yes. I'm terribly sorry. I didn't know. What happened?
She tried to commit suicide.
But what happened to her? I was with her. The last time that I saw her, she seemed... I mean, I didn't see... When was this?
I don't know what happened. She just tried... I don't know anything about it. She...
But is she in hospital? Where is she? Which hospital?
Hello.
Are you surprised to see me?
No, not really. Nice of you to come, but they're going to ask you to leave any second.
Yes, I know. I haven't bought anything, I'm afraid. There was nothing open.
Was it difficult finding it?
No. But it was extremely difficult trying to find you. I had no address. It wasn't easy.
I'm sorry.
Why did you leave that hat in the cafe?
It wasn't mine. I was returning it.
Oh. Got these books of your stories. I brought those.
Thank you. Shall we go for a walk? It's a nice hospital, but the food's always cold. I suppose they can't help that. Have you got any money?
Money? Oh, yes, here. Wait a minute. I want to get rid of all my English loose change. I have at last got my reposting.
Good. Your plan worked. You're going home. You must be pleased.
Yes. It didn't quite happen the way I imagined, though. You know, it's funny. I wasn't being followed at all. I was living in this world of conspiracy with Harmon and me, throwing all that paranoia at each other in all our conversations and... I'm sorry. We ought to.
Please don't feel guilty about anything. It had nothing to do with anything you did.
No,
I like being with you. It's just very silly of me.
Silly?
Would you like a biscuit? It'll use up some of your loose change.
No, no, please. Don't bother.
We just happened to meet when it was already... I mean, it's a car accident. Just sort of threw us together, really. I was just feeling very distant from things. Nothing very special.
Distant?
Yes, sort of... You know, like you're outside, gone outside things, and you feel very light, and... doesn't really matter being there, being anywhere, really. I shouldn't be talking about myself. It's all nonsense. Sorry. Come on, drink up. Why, they'll spot us, and then they'll come and shout at both of us. Did I tell you this? I've been meaning to say this for ages. Your English is really good.
My English? That's all right, I suppose.
I've been meaning to say that for ages. Sounds really stupid now, doesn't it? I've got to go. Or I miss the pills they give us insomniacs and knock us out for the night. Wasn't as bad as you expected, was it? Coming here, seeing me.
Bad? What do you mean, bad?
You know, embarrassing. I really appreciate you coming anyway. You may see him at the hotel again. If you're ever over here.
Celia? You must tell me that you won't do anything like this again.
It's all right. Everything will change. Don't worry about me. I hope it all works out for you when you get back home.
It's too late to see her tonight. Did you see her?
Yes.
I saw her for a few minutes yesterday, that's all. Did she tell you anything?
No.
Will you be able to see her again?
I doubt it. I'm leaving tomorrow, going home. Though what'll happen to me there, I don't know. I suppose we've both been kinds of exiles, me and your daughter. To be alien and stranger in foreign city is bad, but to feel stranger in your own city must be very friendly.
I'll walk a bit further with you, if I can, if you don't mind.
Of course.